Hey guys, so I talked in the previous video about how I obtained the Xenoblade Chronicles disc. I gamified it, pretty much, and that enabled me to be able to play it, this expensive game. So, props to those who got it new when it first, you know, came out. Because that probably was the smartest thing to do, because now, if you want to own this game, you're going to have to spend at least $70 on eBay or any other secondhand market, including GameStop. So that's interesting. Anyway, right off the bat, the opening, I think, is interesting. It kind of starts with the cloud, dark, and then there's a narrator talking about how there is this timeless battle going on between these huge titans. And when I looked at the titans, it kind of looked like gigantic Knight robots. It reminded me a little bit of like the Knight and White Knight Chronicles, the game, but like more kind of robotic. One of the Titans is named Bionis, and the other one is like Mechonis or something like that. So the theme, like I got it out of that one is Bio, one is Mech, so it's like, you know, like a organic thing versus a mechanic thing. That's kind of the theme. The robots kind of look very similar. One is black, one is white. Not the robot, but Titans. They're fighting each other, and they've been at it for timeless eons, and apparently they're huge. So they move very slowly in the cutscene, and they clash when their swords clash, like the oceans underneath them just ripple out. Apparently they battle. No explanation is given why they're battling or how long they've been battling, but eventually they battle on for long, long, long time, and they just turn into corpses. And living along those on those corpses are human societies and civilizations. And I like how it just kind of begins right there. It just zooms in on one of the robots' corpse, or the Titan's corpse, sorry. And there is like a battle going on, explosions and whatnot, talking about how there's a Mechon invasion. And these Mechons are little weird things that are like very mechanical, have like very sharp lancers and things. I like the art design of Mechons. They're very intimidating little enemies and things. And then, of course, the opponents that are like fighting in fear are human soldiers, human beings. So that's kind of where the game begins. I like where the game begins. It has a interesting premise. That there is this humans and Mechons who have been at constant like tension and conflict with each other since who knows when. I like that. And then it begins with the explosion, some are cheating, and then of course we are now introduced to one of the main characters, Dumbad, and his fellow two comrades. One is like this cowardly type character, and the other one has like a gigantic shotgun, and he's more of like a kind of a war grunt. Like, he has this look like, I've been at this war for a long time. Long blonde hair, so he kind of looks like a Vietnam War hippie in a way, which I thought was interesting. The main character himself is also kind of gruffy, long dark brown hair, has a very deep voice. Actually, you know, my first impression when I just saw that character, I was like, looks like an okay guy. Of course, he's headstrong, like, he's been ordered to retreat. He's like, we could do that, that sounds like a good idea. Or, we could fight. Right? I have the Monado. And Monado is the blade that gives him enough power. And I like how the conversation also kind of hints that the Monado is, you can't take any more of the Monado. So Monado is a strain on him. So there is this sword is extremely powerful, but at the same time, the sword drains energy out of the character. And I've already played a good amount of it, so I in hindsight, you know, that kind of gives you a clue as to the fact that Monado is like a sword that is really straining on the user. And that's kind of how it begins. And the first thing I notice is kind of the graphics. There's a lot of details behind it, but it is a Wii game, so there's a lot of grainy aspect. Like, the game overall, like, the visuals look very grainy. But I generally like the art style. It is kind of like the It feels very much like a Japanese RPG, which I like. I love Japanese RPGs, and so up to a really great beginning. And I kind of enjoyed this whole opening sequence of just kind of being, like, the tutorial is these three soldiers, you're controlling Dumbad, essentially, and being introduced to the battle system. This battle is the tutorial, and just waves of Metcon coming, and you're just fighting them off. The battle system is, I think, at least in the tutorial, is pretty simplistic. You tap A when it's time to act upon it, when you're able to, and all the characters pretty much do auto attacks, and you're pretty much setting like special attacks. If you want to do this type of attack, you do it. There's also kind of a special thing that you do with when Monado becomes activated, which I think is interesting. But it is on the Wii, but I do like it that I don't really have to waggle so much. It is just strictly buttons and stuff. For this RPG, I actually like that because I know RPG is going to be super long, and I don't want to have to waggle all the time throughout the experience. So definitely appreciate that. The entire opening sequence is pretty short, but it's a good action sequence. The battle happens, they have to retreat, and then after the retreat, of course, the cowardly person, you know, ends up dying, which I actually thought, you know, that cowardly person could end up to be like one of the main villains later in the game story, but the writer chose not to take that route, which I actually think is a good thing, because I didn't really like that cowardly character, just kind of too stereotypical, kind of cliche in a way. But that's the opening sequence, that kind of battle tutorial, and then the battle ends with them retreating. But the Monado, I really like the also like how powerful Monado is. There's a display of Dumbat can use this Monado sword, and it's really powerful against this Metcon enemy. And there's a cutscene that displays that, and then after this, it does this whole like skip forward to like 3 years later. I forgot like the exact time, but like it just skips to the next sequence. And it begins very peacefully, kind of like, and it also begins with a different new character, which, I don't know, when I was kind of transitioned from Dumbad to this new character, I was just like, I'm not feeling it. I'm more, like, attached to Dumbad right now, and I'm just now getting, like, automatically transitioned to this character. And this character is going to be the main character that I play with, I think, for the rest of the game. But that was pretty much the opening of Xenoblade Chronicles. And in the next video, I will talk more about my experience with the first couple hours of Xenoblade Chronicles.